Donald Trump may have held a dim view of the generals as a candidate.
I know more about ISIS than the generals do, believe me.
But as president-elect, he's changing his tune. After selecting retired General Michael Flynn as National Security Advisor and retired Marine General James Mattis as Defense Secretary, a source tells CNN Trump has chosen retired General John Kelly to head the Department of Homeland Security. Trump also announcing he will tap Iowa Governor Terry Branstad to serve as the next U.S. ambassador to China.
I'm very proud to have supported Donald Trump for president. I think he's going to make America great again.
All of this as Trump puts yet another industry on notice today. After striking a deal with Carrier to keep jobs in the U.S. and warning Boeing about its prices, now Trump may be taking a closer look at pharmaceutical companies. Telling Time magazine, I'm going to bring down drug prices. I don't like what's happened with drug prices. Trump's dabbling in the private sector is all part of the job, he said, as he defended his threat to scrap a deal with Boeing to build new Air Force One jets.
But, you know, that's what I'm here for. I'm going to negotiate prices, and the planes are too expensive.
Thank you, everybody.
But even though Trump's words, whether on television or on Twitter, now move markets, he brushed aside concern that he's using the social media platform to air grievances on everything from Boeing to Broadway shows to Saturday Night Live.
I think I am very restrained, and I talk about important things.
As the often unpredictable billionaire maps out plans for his White House, he's relying on an unexpected source for guidance, President Obama.
I've asked him what he thinks are the biggest problems of the country, what are some of the greatest assets going forward, and we have a very good dialogue. I do like him. I love getting his ideas.
The president is responsive to requests and phone calls from the president-elect, so he's certainly pleased that he can offer advice and assistance that may be useful to the incoming administration.
Today, Trump is basking in his first accolade as president-elect, Time magazine naming him 2016's Person of the Year. But Trump's already taking issue with their headline.
I think putting divided is snarky. But again, it's divided. I'm not president yet, so I didn't do anything to divide.
And while he may not want to take responsibility for rifts in the nation, he's already claiming credit for accomplishments preceding his tenure in the White House.
I hope I'm judged from the time of the election as opposed to from January 20th, because the stock market has had a tremendous bounce and people are seeing very good things for business in this country.
Now there is yet another announcement from Donald Trump tonight. He's chosen Linda McMahon to head the Small Business Administration. She's the former CEO of the WWE. A source familiar with the decision tells me that Donald Trump respects her experience as a businesswoman. That's part of the reason he felt she was the right fit for the job.